My name is Kaytie Innamorati, and we are in the Marenda Lab at Drexel University. My project in the lab is related to an Alzheimer's drug screen. So we've expressed a protein in flies, a human protein, that that will give the flies a phenotype or a expression of just like Alzheimer's in humans. And so we've screened 200, 300 drugs, and we looked at how these drugs affected the way that the flies behaved, if it affected this Alzheimer's phenotype that we'd given them, and if it was able to help their motor coordination, if they were able to remember, and if they were able to learn a behavior and remember it later. Right now, we're looking at about five different drugs that were the best in terms of reducing the severity of the phenotypes that we originally saw. I'm from Carlisle, Massachusetts, which is a little suburb right outside of Boston. It's a small farm town sort of area with some good schools. My grandfather says that I've always wanted to be a marine biologist. My grandmother corrected him and said no, she wanted to be a mermaid. There's a little bit of a difference when I was three. But I then decided I wanted to do marine biology because I wanted to, you know, work with dolphins. I thought that was the greatest thing. Someone told me that's actually not marine biology, but by that point I already had this idea that science is great in my head. And as I got into college and then into graduate school, I started thinking, what do I want to do? And I wanted to help people. I know it sounds cliche, but I really just wanted to alleviate pain. And, you know, there's so many people suffering from these horrible diseases, and I just wanted to do something, and I figured this is the best way that I can help. I am not good at math at all. I have always struggled with it. A lot of people say, oh, I can't be a scientist. I'm terrible at math. That's why I don't like science. There are things in science that don't involve hardcore math. So if you can add and subtract and multiply, there is science that you can do. And we need people who, you know, maybe math isn't your strong point, but that doesn't mean that you're not a good conceptual thinker, you're not good at understanding things and coming up with ideas. You can still be creative if you're not good at math, and that's what we need for science, not just the ability to do math. I'm a first-year graduate student, so I just joined this lab. I've been making myself at home, learning all of the different techniques. So my short-term goals are probably to learn a whole bunch of new techniques that I can bring into the experiment and teach my two undergrads. So be able to work as a team and bring our project kind of into a new place from we don't entirely know what's going on to having really hard evidence that we know what we're seeing, and then hopefully we can start to figure out why. Because that's the best way we can help, you know, in the long term, clinically. We have to know exactly what's going on in order to be able to move forward with it and treat people. Life in the lab it's great, you know, and part of the reason I love this lab is the, you know, nearly family community that we have. We can work with each other, we can talk to each other. It's fun, it's nice and bright and airy, and that's really good for when you're working long hours to be able to at least see the sun outside. It's an enjoyable experience. I mean, if this research turns out, then ideally we'll have a potential new treatment for Alzheimer's that we could get into preclinical and clinical trials, and that would be wonderful because that would help so many people across the world, not even just in the US. If I can, you know, graduate from here and move on to a postdoc where I'm able to bring this research forward, not even this research particularly, but this knowledge and move on to working on other diseases and finding more cures, that would be my dream, I think. What better way to, you know, help change the world than, you know, affecting millions of people, you know, personally, you know, changing their lives for the better just because you decided to spend 5 or 6 years working in a lab. You get to create, you get to brainstorm, you get to think, and it's awesome. And that would be why I would say somebody should get into medical research, because you have the opportunity to help millions of people as a result and learn a lot about yourself in the process.